So there's a couple issues that I've seen so far, lots of them. One, just want to keep it real basic, is how come there was nobody represented at the cultural environmental space over there and the human environment as well? There's no specialists over there. I was wondering the reasons for that. Also, why is Westlands Water District presenting this as if they are going to follow through with this thing and it's already a done deal and we're just here just kind of talking amongst each other and just hanging out and speaking up to try to touch some hearts at least, including the Westlands Water District people who work for these places and are responsible for a lot of things that I don't even know if y'all are aware about. So I wanted to talk about things from the tribal perspective. I don't think none of it has ever, not been said before. All of this has already been said before, about the warnings of how the land is being treated, how the water is being treated, how the animals are being treated. Last but not least, how the people are being treated, how the Winnemem Wintu people are being treated and have been treated and are continuing to be ignored out of existence. I am a Winnemem Wintu person here. I'm in your face right now. Hello, we're all family here, by the way. I'm just wanted to let y'all see me as a representative from where I come from, is right here. Thousands, hundreds of thousands of years, not six, but hundreds of thousands of a continuous life way that has worked for hundreds of thousands of years, which includes spiritual alignment and spiritual reciprocity to sacred places, sacredness of rivers, sacredness of animals, and being in tune with that as communicating has allowed this place to exist for hundreds of thousands of years. Industrial Revolution has been around for 150. Mass extinction is happening as we speak. The rivers are dying. There's consequences to these things. Industrial Revolution isn't as beautiful as everybody thinks it is. To me, this is just a continuation of it, this Shasta Dam. Tons of studies out there, dams don't work, the fish are dying, there's all kinds of science out there supporting this, all right? What I wanna talk about though, real quick while I have enough time, is the consequences of this and the spiritual makeup that I'm talking about that everybody, is aware of, I hope. There's a word card called the karma. And it's a Sanskrit word, and it's not from here, but it's an interesting concept that says that if you destroy this environment so much over and over again, over and over again, and over again, and one more time with these mega projects, that there's going to be a tipping in the scale. And you don't have to say it's karma, but I'm going to use the word karma. And the karmic debt of that says that the consequence of that is that it'll get wiped out. Something is going to happen to humanity. And that's not anything that has to do with me, but I'm trying to correct my own karma in saying that and put the warning out there once again, because it seems to be people have forgotten it, and the including, manipulation of the water, manipulation of life, manipulation of fires, basically the result, watch out for Mount Shasta, watch out for Mount Lassen, watch out for the earthquakes, watch out for more fires, watch out for more droughts, and watch out for our own spiritual debt in all of this. So let's make it correct, let's make it more Christ-like, if that, even in the Bible there's revelations. So thank you.
Thank you.